Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We continue today to search for Abby. We have no additional information as far as that search goes. However, again, the family has asked that you continue to give them their privacy. I know that there are some media outlets that continue to call them, and that has caused distress for the family. So again, I would ask that if there are media inquiries, that they either be made to the Attorney General's office or to the FBI. Despite that, the family is here. They are showing support for this. They want Abby, if she's out there watching, to see their face, to know that they are here for her, that they love her, and they want her home. This evening, a close family friend, Nancy, is going to read a statement on behalf of the family.
Abby, we care about you so much. We miss you, and we want you to come here and be home with us. You're in my thoughts, and we pray that you are safe. Please know how much you care. We care, and you have such a special place in my heart. We love you so much, Abby. Thank you.
Fish and Game will give an update as to the extent of the searches today. I will just give a brief overview. We'll answer a couple questions, and then, barring any additional information, there'll be another press conference tomorrow evening at 6 o'clock. Colonel Garabedian.
Good evening. Search teams today, both with K-9 and our officers, expanded our search into some different areas, both in Conway Village and up here in North Conway. We concentrated around the Pudding Pond area and the Whitaker Woods area, some of the holes that we get to look at what areas have been covered in the past. We determined we might have missed a few areas, so we went back into those today. The search teams are pretty much done for the day, and we still have no additional leads. So again, we can't stress enough, if somebody does have some information, please bring it forward to help us solve this, please.
We have continued to receive tips. Those tips have been followed up on. Again, we have had investigators here from the Attorney General's office, the State Police, the Fish and Game, FBI, as well as other agencies. Any tip that comes in, it's reviewed, and they are all followed up on. As I said yesterday, I think if you begin to ask individuals in the community who have provided those tips, they will tell you that they have been followed up on. An area of concern that has been reported, and we wanted to make again clear, is that we have seen reports that indicated that the night that Abby went missing, there was a phone call that was made at approximately 6:30. To the extent that that information was either given by us or was misunderstood as being given by us, I am here to tell you that that is not accurate information. We do not have a phone call at 6:30 that evening. We have, as we have provided information, that Abby was at school. After that, we are trying to determine every step that she took. So to the extent that that information is out there and individuals may be saying, gee, I saw her, if she talked to somebody at 6:30, I'm not going to report that. We are asking the public to come forward with any information regarding what they could have seen about Abby on either Tuesday, Wednesday, or any day thereafter. That will certainly help us in the search and will help us in locating Abby. We'll take a few questions.
At what point does this scale back, and is the FBI still involved?
The FBI is still involved. They have a number of agents here. We have not begun discussions about scaling it back because, quite frankly, we haven't exhausted the search.
Hopefully you can tell us about the black pickup truck that was pulled over not far from here just before noon time today.
What we can tell you is any lead that comes in, we follow up on. We have had contact with numerous individuals, students, people in the community. I wouldn't read anything into any fact other than that we are doing a thorough job in trying to find Abby.
Shane, yeah, it's for you, Union Leader. So there was no phone call that you gave information about from Cranmore or anywhere near Cranmore. Did Cranmore even be mentioned in any of this?
To the extent that there was information provided that there was a phone call at 6:30 on Wednesday night, that is incorrect information. To the extent of where that phone is, we are scouring that data and trying to determine that. We are trying to pinpoint information in regard to the phone as well as other social media outlets that we're looking
at. Is that phone missing?
You know, I'm not going to comment on that now. certainly if anybody has any information, we would have that, but we are trying to look at all the pieces that we have, and we are trying to put this puzzle together to bring Abby home to her mother and to her sister and to Nancy. One more question. We are getting various leads. We are getting leads from students. We are getting leads from the public. We are following up on data. So I can't categorize it as to say that they are all types of leads that are being followed up on. I think that I had spoken with somebody earlier today. Part of the reason that the FBI and other agencies are here are that we have people that have skill sets. So we are utilizing individuals' skill sets to target certain information. We have people that will go out in the community. We will have people that will look at the social media, look at phones. We are utilizing everything we can, and we are grateful and we are thankful for all the support that we have gotten through the federal government, through the local, through Fish and Game, and through everyone who else has come forward. I think the chief has told us that there have been other departments in the state who have called to offer their help. It's only when you see this concerted effort that we are going to be able to find Abby, and we're going to be able to bring her home. Thank you. We'll see you tomorrow night at 6 o'clock.